The key to success is to focus on goals, not obstacles. Bill discounting.
Here are a few key problems from bill discounting, from part B and part C. Right? We'll go through each of these questions.
Along with other problems in the textbook, practice these problems as well.
So first one, find the banker's discount on a bill of ₹415 due 9 months at 15% per annum. You need to find banker's discount. What is banker's discount? Banker's discount is nothing but the simple interest calculated on the face value. So if face value, F is the face value, right? Simple interest calculated on this. What is simple interest formula? What is simple interest formula? It is PTR by 100. Right? But here, instead of putting PTR, you put FTR. So this becomes banker's discount. Right? Now, this is one way of remembering this particular formula. Now, FTR. So F is 415, face value. T is 9 months. T should be represented in years. So it is 9 months. So it's 9 by 12. And R is the rate. R is the rate of interest. So just substitute all these values in this particular formula. And you'll get banker's discount. Here's the second problem. A banker pays 2380 on a bill of 2500 73 days before the legally due date. Find the rate of discount charged by the banker. So you'll have to find R, right? You have to find R here. You have to find R. So face value is given. Face value is 2500, right? Bill of 2500. So this is the face value. Banker pays 2380. That means this is a discounted value, right? Since the banker is paying, it is nothing but discounted value. Discounted value is 2380. T is 73 days. From the 73 days before the legally due date. 73 days before the legally due date means 73 by 365, which is 1/5 of year. First, what is the discounted value formula? We'll have to use the discounted value formula, which is F into 1 minus TR, right? F is 2500. T is 73 days before the legally due date. So you have to first find T in terms of years, right? It is 73 days, convert it to years. So it will be 73 by 365, which is 1/5, right? So when I substitute, I'll get R as 24%. Let's look at the third problem. A bill drawn for 3 months was legally due on this particular date. Find the date of drawing of the bill. What is legally due date? It is nothing but when I add date of drawing with 3 grace days and the bill period, I get the legally due date. Now in this question, legally due date is given. You have to find the date of drawing, right? You have to find this and legally due date is given. So what I'll do? From the legally due date, I will subtract bill period, I will subtract grace days and I will get date of drawing. So 6th July 2018, if I remove 3 months from it, it's going to be April and 3 days before 6th, which is 3rd April 2018. Let's go to the fourth problem. A bill for ₹12,900 was drawn on 3rd Feb 2014 at 6 months. And discounted on 13 March 2014 at 8% PA. For what sum was the bill discounted? So for what sum was the bill discounted? This means you have to find the discounted value. Right? So the actual face value of the bill is 12,900. Bill period is 6 months. It is drawn on 3rd Feb, which means it's the date of drawing. Right? Date of discount is 13th March 2014, right? This is date of discount. R is given as 8%, which is 8 by 100, which is 0.08. What do we have to find? We have to find discounted value. What is the formula for discounted value? It is F minus BD. So you can use two formulas for discounted value, right? You can either use face value minus banker discount, or you can say discounted value is equal to phase value into 1 minus TR. Either of these formulas you can use, right? I've used banker discount. You can also use this particular formula. Phase value is there. R is there. We don't know what T is, right? How do we find T? They have given drawing date. They have given the bill period, which is 6 months. So with that, you can find legally due date, right? Drawing date is 3rd February. 6 months is the bill period. 3 days is the grace period. When I add all this, I'll get legally due date. Now I'll count the number of days from 3rd February to 6th August. To 6th August, I'll count the number of days. It's 146 days, right? So I'll put 146 by 365 here. Either you use this formula or this formula and you'll get the discounted value. Let's go to fifth problem. Banker's discount and banker's gain on a certain bill due after some time are rupees 1250 and 50. Find the phase value of the bill. So you have to find phase value. Banker discount is given. Banker's gain is given. Right? Now, what is the formula for phase value? Straightforward. Banker's discount into true discount by banker's gain. This is the formula. Right? To get the phase value. We have banker's discount. We have banker's gain. But we don't know what true discount is. So, we'll have to find true discount. Banker's gain is banker's discount minus true discount. Right? Banker's gain is banker's discount minus true discount. So, you know banker's gain. You know banker's discount. Find the true discount. So, you'll get true discount. Now, take this true discount value and put in this particular formula here. Right? So, I'll get the phase value. Sixth problem. Banker's gain on a bill due 6 months. So, bill period is there. At rate 4%, R is there. Is 20. So, banker's gain is 20 rupees. Find the true discount, banker's discount and bill amount. So, let's find true discount. What is true discount formula? True discount is there in two formulas, right? One is this one. TD is BG by TR. Second one is in this particular formula. In the banker's gain formula, you have true discount. Now, we'll use this particular formula. Reason is, we have banker's gain. We know the time, right? Time is 6 months, which is 6 by 12. We know R, which is 4%. So, we can use this formula and get true discount directly. We know true discount. We know banker's gain. So, we'll find banker's discount, right? We need to find the bill amount. What is the bill amount? This is nothing but the phase value. This is nothing but the phase value. So, we'll use this formula. BD is equal to FTR, right? We anyway know what is BD by TR. So, we'll substitute banker's discount and time and rate and you'll get the phase value. Let's look at seventh problem. The banker's gain on a bill is 1/5 of the banker's discount and rate of interest is 20%. Find the unexpired period of the bill. So, unexpired period is nothing but T. We need to find T. So, banker's gain is 1/5 of banker's discount. So, banker's gain is 1/5 of banker's discount. R is given 20%. We need to find T. We can use true discount formula. Here you have T, right? So, in true discount, the formula is FTR by 1 plus TR. We don't know phase value. We have to find T and R is given. So, what we will do is, we'll use an additional formula, which is phase value is equal to BD into TD by BG, right? We know BG, which is BG is 1/5 of BD. So, now here BD and BD will get cancelled. We'll be left with 5 TD. So, phase value is 5 times of true discount. Now, we substitute, instead of F, we put 5 TD. So, here TD and TD will get cancelled. And you can find out the value of T. T is 1.25 years. Let's go through 8th problem. For rupees 512.50, due 6 months, so bill period 6 months, R is 15%. Find the true present value and discounted cash value. So, we'll have to find the present value. What is the formula of a present value? It is F by 1 plus TR. So, F is given here. This is 512. T is 6 months. So, 6 by 12, which is half. And R is 15% here. So, now you substitute, you'll get the true present value. What is the formula for discounted cash value? It is F into 1 minus TR. So substitute face value, substitute T and R. You will get discounted cash value. Let's go to the ninth problem. The banker's discount and true discount on a sum of money due 3 months are ₹154.5 and ₹150. Find the sum of money and rate of interest. So, due 3 months. So, bill period is 3 months. Banker's discount and true discount are given. Right? This is banker's discount and 150 is true discount. Find the sum of money. Sum of money is nothing but face value and you have to find rate of interest. So, banker's discount is given here, 154.5. True discount is ₹150. We need to find face value and we need to find the rate of interest. Time is given as 3 months. That is 3 by 12, which is 0.25 years. Now, what is the formula for BD? BD is equal to FTR. So, here you have F and you have R. Right? So, we don't know F, we don't know R. We know T and we know banker's discount. Now, we'll go to the other formula. We'll go to the true discount formula. What is true discount formula? FTR by 1 plus TR. Again, here also we don't know F, we don't know R. We'll substitute everything else. So, what we can do is, from this first equation, from the BD equation, from the banker's discount equation, you can find out F, right? You can just find out F here. So, it will be, F will be 154 by 0.25 R, right? F will be 154 by 0.25 R. So, now that F will substitute here in the true discount. Instead of F, we'll put 154 by 0.25. Right? And then, F is substituted. Now, we'll have to find R value. So, R you will get as 12%. Now, we'll have to find face value. So, we'll come back to this equation. Right? We know R. We'll substitute R. We'll get face value. Let's go to 10th problem. A bill for ₹3,500, this is the face value, due for 3 months, bill period, drawn on 27th March, so drawing date is given, discounted on 18th April, so discount date is given, at the rate of 7%, R is 7%, find the banker's discount. Now, what is the formula for a banker's discount? So, here, it is slightly tricky, right? Time is given as 3 months. Right, but you should not put T as 3 months. You have to find the unexpired period. That is, you have to take from the drawing date till the discounted date, you have to calculate the number of days. Right, that number of days will become T. T is going to be the number of days between drawing date minus discounted date.
Minus 3 grace days.
So, drawing date is 27th March. And discounted date is 18th April 2015. So, when I calculate, I will get 73 days. I will get 73 days. Right? Now, I know what T is. So, now, what is the banker's discount? So, banker's discount is F into TR. F is 3,500. Into time is 73 days by 365. R is 7%, 7 by 100. So, when I calculate this, I will get rupees 49 as the answer. So, this is banker's discount. So, let's go to the 11th problem. True discount on a bill was rupees 100. Banker's gain was rupees 10. What is the face value of the bill? So, true discount is given. Banker's gain is given. We need to find the face value. Now, where do we have face value? In which formula? In banker's discount. Right? Also, banker's gain is given. What is the formula for banker's gain? Banker's discount minus true discount. Banker's gain is given, true discount is given. We can find banker's discount here. From this formula, we can find banker's discount. Right? Banker's discount would be BG plus TD. Right? We have both BG and TD. Right? So here, we'll find banker's discount, which is 110 rupees. Now, we'll substitute 110 here. We'll substitute 110 here. Face value, we don't know. TR also, we don't know. That means we'll have to use third formula. These two formulas are not going to help us. We'll have to use third formula, which is BG is equal to TD into TR. TD into TR. We know banker's gain. We know true discount. We'll find TR here. Right? We'll find TR here. So, we'll get TR is equal to 0.1. Now, use this TR here. Whatever TR you get, use it here in this formula. F is there. We know banker's discount. We got 110, right? Now, using this, we can find face value, right? So, face value is going to be 1100 rupees. This is little tricky because three formulas have to be used. So ensure that you remember all the formulas, all the variations of the formula if you have to solve this problem. Last problem, the banker's gain on a certain sum of money. Certain sum of money means face value due in 6 months. T is 6 months. Banker's gain is 27. Find the face value of the bill if the rate of interest is 6%. So we need to find the face value. So here we'll use BG is equal to TD into TR because banker's gain is given. Now again, like earlier problem, you have to remember all the banker gain formulas, right? One formula is BD minus TD. The other formula for banker's gain is TD into TR. We know T, we know R, right? And we know banker's gain. So we can find TD, right? We can find true discount. Now, this is the other formula for face value, right? BD into TD by BG. So we'll get TD from here. Put TD here. We know banker's gain, right? Now, what is banker's discount? We need to find banker's discount to find F. How do we find banker's discount? Use this formula. BG is equal to BD minus TD, right? So you'll get banker's discount. Now you substitute banker discount here, right? And I'll get the face value
like this.
So face value is 30,900 rupees.
With this, we've come to the end of this particular video. If you like this video, do press a like and share it. Thank you.